it's a search where we filtered and manipulated data based on controlled release. But what if instead you had a class of compounds? I mentioned before that we were going to do alkylphenol as a class of compounds. This is type of information that you may search when you do this free text formulation search. When I execute this search in alkylphenols, we'll see that nice thing is that we're picking that up because this is a class of compounds. It could be methyl phenol. It could be, you know, any other of the phenols. We're going to see that one of the nice things that we do at CAS is we also do Markush structures, and that Markush information is included within the CAS formulas tool. We'll have that. But what I want to focus in on is cosmetics and personal care. And point out a nice feature is that if you're looking for a broad class of substances and you would like to see a little bit more about what are the actual substances that people have reported on in the literature, this comes from a patent from Johnson & Johnson, and we'll see that their alkylphenols are covering things like butylphenol. We can click on that, get a structure, maybe gain access to the CAS registry number and view ingredient detail if we would like to. We can see the formulations for this particular material and even have access to suppliers. I do like to point out that, you know, because this is a CAS product, that CAS formulations and formulas recognizes CAS registry numbers. So if that's a way that you're more common, that you're more accustomed to searching, that is certainly a capability that we have. So I like to show those simple searches, but I want to go back to the homepage, and we're going to change gears just a little bit and take a look at a specific ingredient. We looked at formulations that contained a specific keyword, you know, whether it was alkylphenol or controlled release, but maybe what you are more interested in is looking into the details of a specific ingredient. I can use a name, CAS registry number, or you can even search on a function if you just wanted to see every excipient that we have within the database as an example. I'm going to look at lidocaine. We'll see that the auto text is helping us out, making sure that our spelling is on point, which is often an issue with me. And we'll execute this search. And what we are going to see now are the substances that match that query. Now, this is designed to be one substance, but if you put a space, you can search for multiple substances, multiple registry numbers if you want to. We'll see that we have filters capability here. And this gives you an idea of some of the regulatory lists. Now, this is one compound, so all of these regulatory lists appear within this substance. We will take a look into the view details, but immediately what you'll have access to are the key features that we had consulted with formulators that were most important to them. So we see molecular weight. We'll indicate whether it's an experimental melting point or boiling point, and even give you conditions, you know, particularly important to boiling point. But what I want to do is view the details. I want to see more about this compound. So let's go ahead and click onto that. It automatically opens in a new, it automatically opens when you click there. We'll see. All right, we still have access to those key features, but now we'll see commonly used as. What we have done is made sure to include within the substance information what the features and uses for this substance have been in the literature, what our analysts have extracted out of the body of literature. So if I wanted to see instances where lidocaine was an anesthetic, which is most commonly what it is going to be, and that's because of the order, we put the most common and most prolific terms at the top, we could view those formulations. I can open that in a new tab. And what that will do, I just want to show an example, is that will link our substance with that specific function. So now we're going to see the 6,200 formulations where lidocaine is used as an anesthetic. We can go through any of these that we would like to, but I'm just going to condense these down. Commonly formulated with can be very beneficial. This is also ordered by the number of instances where these two components have been together. So water appears a lot, but if you were looking for the most common ingredient that was mixed with a specific ingredient, in this case lidocaine, you would be able to tell that from this list here. This is ordered in descending order. So we can see water is the most common, glycerol is number two, and then go on down if we would like to the things that maybe are less commonly formulated with, but might be able to open your research up to new opportunities or new ideas. Regulatory information. If there's a specific regulatory list that you are curious about, ask a question, we'll see, we'll make sure to cover that in the question is answered. I like to pick this substance because there is a lot of regulatory coverage here. Some of the more important regulatory authorities that we cover is the ANAMAT from Argentina. We cover quite a bit from the European continent, FDA Green Book, also FDA Orange Book. We cover things like generally regarded as safe information. We also cover things like actives and inactive ingredient information as well. But once again, if there's a specific a regulatory list that you would like to see, let us know and we'll address that. But we consulted our formulation consults to find out what were the best formulation or what were the best regulatory lists for the formulation scientists. And that's what we've included here. So you have quick access to what is said about this particular material from a formulation from a formulation focus. One thing I will also point out, let me go ahead and close down the regulatory information. Our other names. This really highlights the power of the registry number. Registry numbers are assigned and they are linked with things like trade names, but also systematic names. So the nice thing is that whether you're searching for you know, the word lidocaine, the registry number, or any other way that a manufacturer has marketed this material, you will have confidence in knowing that the registry number is going to hit on the substance that you're interested in. Our analysts at CAS maintain our names and make sure that they do indeed hit on exactly what is intended and what is required. From an intellectual indexing standpoint, they make those connections. And if there are changes, they will update changes to registry numbers to make sure that the names do indeed match the CAS registry number and also match the substance.